Hi everyone, welcome to my presentation. I'm Şükran Karaosmanoğlu from the University of Hamburg. Today I will present the paper Feels Like Team Spirit, Biometric and Strategic Interdependence in Multiplayer VR Games. Providing engagement for all players is important in multiplayer games. However, people differ in their abilities, preferences and access to certain hardware devices. For example, VR headsets are increasingly available but still not accessible to everyone. Head-mounted displays offer highly immersive experiences for the people wearing them. But what happens to non-VR users in such a context? Research involving both users is increasingly exploring asymmetries, suggesting that asymmetries can improve player experiences on both parties. But what is asymmetry? Asymmetric games take into account the differences between players in the design process to improve player experiences for all users. What is interdependence then? Interdependence can be defined as reliance on each other. This can be created through the use of asymmetric game mechanics. This trend is also happening in the commercial market where VR games use asymmetries to engage players. Another important aspect is biometrics. It is expected to be an increasingly common type of interaction in future games, yet it has not been explored as an interdependence. Also, research indicated that VR users often like sound for their biometric feedback, but it has not been tested in an asymmetric game context. Therefore, in our study, we asked the following research questions. Does asymmetry of information cause one player to feel less in control? How does biometric interdependence affect the player experience in VR, and if so, in what modality should it be represented? To answer these questions, we created an asymmetric VR game and used asymmetry of interfaces between players. The VR player was wearing an HMD. The non-VR player experienced the game on a PC monitor while wearing a heart rate sensor. We further introduced other asymmetries to create interdependences. First, the strategic interdependence referred to the differences in game information and player capability. We employed this in a virtual grid guidance and in solving a memory puzzle. While the non-VR player had more information, the VR player was responsible for physically navigating the game. The second interdependence was the difference in player's biometric influence. We linked the game difficulty to heart rate of the non-VR player, and this affected the frequency of lasers. While the non-VR player was able to see and hear the approaching lasers, the VR player lacked this information and needed to duck based on the non-VR player's instructions. In some conditions, we provided audio, visual, and a combination of them as indicators to non-VR players for increased heart rate metrics. We conducted a mixed design user study with the resulting 5 conditions and obtained both quantitative and qualitative data. Our results show that strategic interdependence was appreciated by all players. This was also reflected in the quantitative data. Both player roles showed high positive player experience scores. In terms of biometric interdependence, we did not find any significant difference in the quantitative data. However, the qualitative data showed that it did affect immersion, stress, and agency of players. In fact, some players explicitly stated that they felt the influence of their bodies on the game. Finally, our key takeaways. Strategic interdependence can provide a similarly high positive player experience for both VR and non-VR players. Biometric interdependence and indicators were subject to learning effects and to subtle implementation, yet it affected the immersion and stress of both players. VR players could hear the tension in the voices of non-VR players. This is essentially a mirroring effect of biometric influence, which is an interesting finding because hearing a bystander's voice can be perceived as a potential comfort factor by VR users. We also observed the need for longitudinal data of heart rate metrics, which aligns with other studies showing longitudinal data need in VR in general. Lastly, the agency is a key factor in asymmetric games, but neither low nor high agency is inherently perceived as bad or good. Future studies can consider exploring unbalanced power distributions to improve multiplayer engagement, which again goes back to the definition of asymmetries in games. People may differ in their abilities and preferences. Thank you so much for listening to this talk. Please refer to our paper or reach me or my co-authors for further details.